Good morning, boys and girls. Welcome back to Sunday School. Today, we are still in the book of Matthew. We are going to be talking about one of Jesus's miracles this morning. Does anybody know what a miracle is? You can think in your head or tell your mom, dad, sister, brother, whoever you're watching with this morning. A miracle is something that only God can do. Jesus did many miracles while he was on earth, proving that Jesus is God's son. When I was little, we lived in Florida for a little while. We had a pool in our backyard, which was super, super exciting. But I loved, when I was a kid, the story of Jesus walking on water. It was one of my very favorite miracles because I loved being in the water. I loved swimming. I loved playing in the pool. And so thinking about walking on water was so cool and exciting to me. So the idea that Jesus could walk on water was amazing. And I used to love to read about how he tried to have his disciples walk on water, and they could do it for a little bit if they had faith in him, but when they started to become afraid, they might slip underneath. And I spent so long in our backyard trying to figure out how I could walk on water just like Jesus did. I never was able to do it, but it still was one of my favorite stories to hear, how Jesus had so much power as God's son that he could change the laws of how nature worked, and he was able to walk on water just like it was dry land. So this morning, if you haven't guessed already, we are going to be learning about this story about when Jesus walked on water. So the picture I'm going to show you this morning, to kind of get your mind thinking about it, is a carving from a church that's showing this event. It's located in a cave church in Egypt called Saint Simon the Tanner. We're gonna learn more about this story after our time of worship, so come back.
Everything he does, he keeps his promises, we know, because, yeah. right, boys and girls, welcome back for our scripture time. We are going to be in the book of Matthew again. So I'm going to go back to our table of contents. Remember that Matthew is the first book of the New Testament. So I'm going to flip back and find the New Testament. Oh, and here's the New Testament. Here's the book of Matthew. And this week we are reading out of chapter 14. So I'm going to flip over until I see the big number 14 in my Bible. And there it is over here. All right, and we are going to be reading from verses 25 through 33. So it's right here in my Bible, or 22, excuse me, through 33. And I'm going to go ahead and read it out loud. Follow along in your Bible if you can. Immediately he made the disciples get into the boat and go before him to the other side while he dismissed the crowds. And after he had dismissed the crowds, he went up on the mountain by himself to pray. When evening came, he was there alone. But the boat by this time was long away from the land, beaten by the waves, for the wind was against them. And in the fourth watch of the night, he came to them walking on the sea. But when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified and said, "It is a ghost." And they cried out in fear. But immediately Jesus spoke to them and said, "Take heart, it is I. Do not be afraid." All right, and I encourage you to read the rest of this story with your family later on this week. Again, Matthew chapter 14. We're going to finish the rest of it in our Sunday school time.
All right, welcome back. I'm going to go ahead and retell the Bible story as you look at the picture from our story this morning, and then we'll talk a little bit more about it. After Jesus fed over 5,000 people, Jesus made the disciples get into a boat and go across the Sea of Galilee ahead of him. After the crowds left, Jesus went up the mountain and prayed a long time into the middle of the night. Later, while the disciples were sailing across the sea, a storm came. The waves beat against the boat. The wind blew fiercely. In the very early morning, as it stormed, Jesus came walking on the sea to the disciples. When the disciples saw him, they were very, very scared. "It's a ghost," they yelled in fear. "Have courage. Don't be afraid," Jesus told the disciples. "If it's you, Lord," Peter said, "tell me to walk to you on the water." "Come," Jesus said to Peter. Peter climbed out of the boat and began walking on the water towards Jesus. But when Peter saw the wind of the sea, the power of the wind, he became afraid and began to sink. "Lord, save me," Peter cried to Jesus. Jesus reached out and grabbed Peter's hand. "You have little faith. Why do you doubt me?" Jesus asked Peter. When they reached the boat and climbed in, the wind stopped. The disciples worshiped Jesus and said, "You are the Son of God." So why do you think the disciples were afraid when they saw Jesus? Do you think you would be afraid? I think I would be so afraid if I was in a boat and there was a big storm and all of a sudden I saw someone walking across the water. I think I would be really afraid too, right? I've never seen anyone walk across water. The disciples hadn't either. You can't just walk on water. So of course, they're very, very afraid. But what does Jesus do? He calls out to them, right? They know Jesus' voice. They're friends with him. They've spent time with him. And he's like, "Hey guys, don't be afraid. It's just me. Don't be scared." And remember, Peter gets to walk on the water too. He comes out of the boat and he's doing great until the wind scares him and he began to fall. Peter screams out, and what does Jesus do? He saves him. Do you ever have bad days or even bad weeks or seasons that feel scary? Sometimes in our lives, we go through tough times, right? This year has been tough for many of us, not being able to see our friends and our family or go to school in the way that we normally do. And sometimes we get scared and afraid. But just like Peter did when he was scared and afraid, we can call out to God and save us. God wants us to remember that he loves us. Jesus saved Peter as soon as he got into the boat and the storm stopped. And Jesus will be with us through the tough times too. We know through seeing these miracles that we learn about in the Bible that Jesus is the Son of God. We can remember that God is always with us and he always can help us have courage in any storm or hard thing that we're going through in our lives. All right, we're going to turn it over to Joel for our Explore the Bible time.
If you want to get across water, what do you need? You need a boat, a paddleboard, water skis, inner tubes, or some other flotation device. But what if I told you there was someone who got across the water with their feet?
Sweet! We found it. This is the Courageous Pages Children's Experience at the Museum of the Bible. I'm so excited to go inside. Someone told me there might be a place in here where I can walk on water. I seriously hope so. Turn in your Bibles to Matthew chapter 14 and get ready to discover that Jesus is Lord over all creation. I'm Joel, this is Explore the Bible, and I'll see you inside. Here we are at the Courageous Pages Children's Experience. There's so many cool things in here. Here's what I want to do first. I want to play all the games, and I want you guys to guess what Bible story each game represents. Sound good? What should we do first? Let's do this one. Ooh, this looks cool. All right, let's read the instructions. It says, get all the little fishies into all the baskets to feed the crowds. I don't know what that means, but it sounds fun. Oh, here are the fishies. Aren't they cute? All right, fishies, it's time to go in the baskets. Oh, drop the fishy. Here we go. Huh. Nope. Huh. I got one in. All right, fishies, all together. Yeah. Yeah, this is like the most fun game ever. Okay, I want you guys to think, what Bible story has lots of fish going into lots of baskets to feed lots of people? That's right, the story of the miraculous loaves and fishes. You guys are so smart. I gotta know what that is. Okay, okay. So this next one, it says, hit the scary guy in the forehead with one of the balls using the catapult. Catapult. Okay. Smiley face. That guy's not gonna be smiling for long. Take this, scary guy! That's kinda cool, but I missed. Try again. Hey, big scary guy, what's that over there? Hi-yah! I did it! It was like, yup! And he was like, oh, and I was like, yeah! Can you guys guess what Bible story this game is based on? That's right, David and Goliath. You come at me with swords and spears, I come at you in the name of the Lord. Let's play that one. All right, let's do this one. The instructions say, step between the pillars and try to push them over. It doesn't sound too bad. You're just gonna push the... Okay, we got a problem. Because these pillars aren't immovable. But I want to tell you something. These pillars have a problem. Because I had a protein shake for breakfast. Check this out. Yeah, yeah. Did you guys see that? Bet you saw that. That was kind of scary. Can you guys guess what this game represents? Come on, which Bible story? That's right, Samson. That was fun. I want to do that one.
After Jesus fed the multitudes, he sent everyone away, including his disciples in the boat. Jesus went on the mountain to pray. And when he was done, he was on the seashore looking out at the disciples struggling to row their boat against the heavy wind. Jesus needed to get to them, but he didn't have a boat. What would he do? Jesus stepped onto the waves coming onto the shore, and guess what? His foot did not sink into the water. Step after step, Jesus walked on the water and over the waves. Jesus is the Son of God, so he is omnipotent. This means he has power over everything, even the power to walk on water.
Oh, wow. Here it is. This is the walking on water exhibit. Oh, I know all about this. All right, let's read the instructions. Walking on water. Just like Jesus and Peter walked on water, you have the opportunity to walk across this water yourself. You guys think I can do it? Let's try. All right. Yeah, that feels weird. I feel like I'm gonna sink. But I'm gonna do it for you guys. Come on, Joel. Just ever so lightly. Whoa, this is weird. It's like walking on a watery balance beam. I'm like a water gymnast. All right, next step. I'm gonna go backwards for safety. We're here. You guys see the fish? They're staring at me. They're like, what are you doing walking on top of our heads? I don't know. Whoa, we're good. I'm just gonna ease off. I did it! I'm not wet. I'm a little sweaty, but I'm definitely not wet. This is a piece of cake. Let's do this again. You guys impressed? You're impressed, right? Of course you are. Now, I do have to tell you something. This is not real water. Okay. But in our story, Jesus walked on real water. And guess what? He wasn't the only one. I'm gonna Irish step dance some more.
The disciples could see someone walking on the water, but they couldn't tell who it was, so they were very afraid. Peter called to Jesus and said, "Lord, if it's you, command me to come to you on the water." Jesus said, "Come." Peter stepped out of the boat, onto the water, except he did not sink. Just like Jesus, Peter walked on the water towards the Lord. But Peter got distracted by the strong winds and he began to sink. Peter cried out to the Lord, and Jesus took Peter by the hand and lifted him back up. They both walked towards the boat and got in. Amazed, the men in the boat bowed down to Jesus and worshiped him because Jesus is the Son of God.
Wow, what an amazing story. Jesus has all authority over all creation, including water. What's impossible for us? Is not impossible for Jesus. And just like Peter, Jesus wants to empower you and me to follow him. And that's what we discover when we dig into the book of Matthew. I'm Joel, and this is Explore the Bible on Location. Oh, and this is my new friend. His name is Pages. Pages the Courageous Lion. He's a nice lion. He's not a mean lion. He loves to explore the Bible. Hey, Pages, you want to go walk on water with me? Pages? He gets shy on camera.
Hey everyone, happy Sunday. I am so excited for today's activity because it's going to involve some sort of a challenge in a way. So what we're gonna do is we're going to make boats, but I don't want you guys to make any boats. I want you to make boats that actually float. So in today's story, we learned about Jesus walking on the water and boats were involved in that story. So I thought this would be fun to try to find a challenge so that we can get something to float. So to make a boat that floats, we would need to think of something that isn't something that might sink. So like if we use just paper to make our boat, it might just fall apart and sink. So we have to use something like foil. Foil is something really good to use. You can like make it squared up, like, or like a bowl or something. I don't know, I'm not taking much time on this, but you guys can be so much more creative. But foil is something that's really good at floating or not getting water in it. Or plastic wrap, maybe you're creative enough that you can use like straws and plastic wrap to somehow make a boat. Maybe you have popsicle sticks left over from a craft that we've done recently. Maybe you have popsicle sticks. Or you wanna use a straw and some paper. If you wanted to cut it into a little triangle and you make a mast with your little flag, you could do that. Be as creative as you want and then see if your boat floats. You can get like a container, or maybe when you're about to go take a bath or something, you turn on the tub, you see if it floats in there. Something. Try to get your boat to float and it'll be super exciting because it's a challenge. Because sometimes things float, sometimes they don't. The water might come in, who knows. Hope you have so much fun with this activity and hopefully your boat floats.